Mike, good evening. Yeah, that's right. Now, the Immaculate Heart of Mary Church sits behind me tonight. It did sustain some damage and some water damage earlier today. As everyone knows, this storm hit pretty hard for really a matter of at least a few hours. Police and fire crews were going nonstop. One after the other, the power of lightning strikes were on display all over the Pittsburgh region. Photographs and video.
Wow!
Awe-inspiring, but also damaging. At the Immaculate Heart of Mary Catholic Church in Polish Hill, lightning struck down on the highest center dome.
Fire was contained in a small area, and it never really spread from that area.
And on Orchard Street in McKeesport, it was even worse.
Bolt of lightning from top of the hill, and it turned into a big fireball.
A viewer captured this video just moments after that bolt struck the back of this home. The house flooded with thick smoke quickly. Here, fire crews had just rescued a 54-year-old man off of the roof when the man and his 8-year-old grandson found that that was the only way to escape. Fortunately, before crews arrived, the man was able to drop his grandson down into his neighbor's arms.
He dropped him straight down. The four of us grabbed him. It was perfect.
But while no people were injured after the lightning strike here, the homeowner, with his heartache clearly visible, lost two of his three dogs to smoke inhalation as they became trapped on the second floor.
He's going home to see his other brothers. He's trying to go home to see my other two dogs.
My loved ones is the only thing I care about. Okay. The other two people in the house and my other two dogs.
And so the grandfather and the grandson at the McKeesport home were taken to a hospital, but were released a short time later. As for the Immaculate Heart of Mary Church, it is unclear at this point tonight if it will be open in time for tomorrow's Mass. Reporting live, I'm Andrew Del Greco, Channel 4 Action News.
Andrew, you have to check this out tonight. Water simply gushing out of a manhole cover. This video sent in by Michael Dessou as the water just swallowed Broadway Avenue. This is Glassport. This is the second time in a week this area has flooded. This was one of 22 calls fire crews responded to tonight, just in Glassport alone. About 10 minutes away in McKeesport, one viewer captures a river of water rolling down the road right into neighbors' homes, leaving countless property owners a soggy mess to wade through on Eden Park Avenue. And how about this? People sloshing through sewage, stuck with several inches, even feet, of standing water in their homes. Action News reporter Kelly Brennan gets an up-close tour as she walks down those steps into some waterlogged basement.
We're taking you inside one of the homes in Penn Hills where flooding has been an ongoing issue for 3 years now in the basement. So right now, all of the belongings in this house are simply just floating across the floor. We're at about 3 to 4 inches of water inside.
Like, I don't know what to do anymore. Like, I can't keep replacing this stuff. Like, I'm throwing things out.
Rosita Ellison is tired of this. And every time
it rains, it gets like this. Like, this is probably the second to the worst that this has been.
From outside her Penn Hills home on Beulah Road, you wouldn't know that this is what's inside.
It's overflowing from the manhole covers.
Yes. Yes. I mean, it just gushes out like a geyser.
And just next door, Brian Lefevre spent hours cleaning out his basement, but not from inches of water.
Buckets of sewage, not water. They're right there.
He says the municipality put a grinder pump in his front yard, but it didn't work. We have not been able to reach Penn Hills for comment on this.
There's the buckets. I just left them out because they smell.
The problems don't stop here. We found the same backups in this Carnegie neighborhood. It's the second time they've cleaned out in a week.
I think I'm more upset than anything that nothing didn't get done the last time it happened. If things were fixed, I wouldn't have to go through this again. We wouldn't be here.
For Rosita, it's enough to push her over the edge.
And it comes straight from the garage, and it runs all the way down in there, and it floods all this stuff right here. Ooh, look. Ah!
Reporting in Penn Hills, I'm Kelly Brennan, Channel 4 Action News.